Hey guys, what's up? This is your friend Mainak from Civil Center and I welcome all of you back to our channel and another video on Tekla Structural Designer. So friends, in today's video we'll show you how to model slant roof in Tekla Structural Designer. That is, if a roof has two different levels. As you can see here, this is a roof which has been slant. This portion is more and this portion height is less. So how to model the slant roof in Tekla Structural Designer, we'll show you that using the option of your slope planes. And in the next part, we'll show you how to create this infill beams. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So we'll just open a new project so that we can proceed for making the model. So first of all, let us define some levels using the model option. We'll just quickly define those. Insert below, let's insert a level of -1.2 meters, and here we'll insert level above it. Let's say it will be 3.2 meters. It will be top of steel because I want steel structures, and another level I want, okay, let us do it as 3 meters, and we can insert another level above it of spacing 0.4 meters. So we are done with that, and after that we'll go to the base level. As you can see, these levels have been created, so we'll go to the base level and we'll create some grid lines. So I'll create a grid line of say 6 meters, and I'll create a parallel grid line to it of let's say 7 meters, and then I can take the grid line from here and I can join the grid lines, or I can even use this option so that I have some extension. And if you want to extend this, you can also do it. So we can do like this if we want to extend this grid lines. We can extend it as per our choice by selecting on, then clicking on a node and then dragging the particular node. Okay, like this we can increase the grid lines. Now we'll just insert some steel columns. Please know that you can change the properties of the columns as per your preference. Now I'm just going to insert it one and then two, three, and then four. So now I'm going to change the properties of this particular two columns. For these two columns, I'll just change the top level to structure one. So if I go to the 3D view, as you can see, these columns have different height now. Now I can just model the beams here. So for modeling the beams, I can just go to the beam option. Again, you can just select any beam section you want, but I'm just inserting the beams right here. So now the beams have been done. Now if I want to create some roof in here, how will I do it if I cannot do it from the top view of the structure 1 or the structure 2, because it is a slant roof? How to do that in the 2D view? So for creating the roof panels, you can go open this particular slopes option in the structure window. So in the structure menu, we can open the slopes option and just click on IP1, and this particular view, that is the view which you have created using the slope plane, will open. And after that you can go to the model option, and then you can create certain roof panels here like this. Double click on the last point like this, you can create some roof panels. We'll check it in our 3D view. As you can see, we have created a roof panel in our 2D view. So like this also, you can also work on your beams. You can also insert beams from here in the 2D view because you have created the slant view. So that's all for today's video. In the next video, we'll show you how to create the internal beams in this particular structure. So friends, stay tuned to our channel and keep commenting, because we go through each and every comment of yours. So that's all. Bye.